అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ టూ సర్వీసెస్ ఆర్ లైక్ ఇండియన్ ఆర్డినెన్స్ ఫ్యాక్టరీ సర్వీస్ అండ్ డిఫెన్స్ ఏరోనాటికల్ క్వాలిటీ అష్యూరెన్స్ సర్వీసెస్. ఐ క్లబ్ దీస్ టూ సర్వీసెస్ వై బికాస్ యు నో దేర్ ఈస్ అ రీజన్ లైక్ సో ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఐ విల్ సీ ఇండియన్ ఆర్డినెన్స్ ఫ్యాక్టరీ. సో వాట్ దే డూ, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ యు నో DRDO ఆర్ సమ్ అదర్ యు నో కంపెనీస్ విల్ డెవలప్ సమ్ యు నో ఐటమ్స్ లైక్ గన్ ఆర్ ట్యాంక్ ఓకే ఆర్ వి సో యు నో ఆల్ ది అమ్యునిషన్ ఆర్ ఆర్మ్స్ రిక్వైర్డ్ ఫర్ ది ఆర్మీ దీస్ కంపెనీస్ విల్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ ఇండియన్ ఆర్డినెన్స్ ఫ్యాక్టరీ ప్రొడ్యూసర్స్ దిస్ వన్ ఓకే గన్స్ ట్యాంక్స్ యు నో మిసైల్స్ ఆల్ దీస్ దే ఓన్లీ ప్రొడ్యూస్ ఆర్డినెన్స్ ఫ్యాక్టరీ. సో సి హూ క్రియేట్ ది మిసైల్ ఆర్ గన్స్ హూ డిజైన్ DRDO ఓకే DRDO is like a research and development, and when they develop, then these people will, you know, produce us, Indian Ordnance Factory Services, okay. So, Indian Ordnance Factory Board is there, you know, I think it is in the Kolkata. So, there is a different levels of structure, so again, we are not worrying about that. Your entry level is here is AWM, Works. అసిస్టెంట్ వర్క్స్ మేనేజర్ ఆర్ వర్క్షాప్ మేనేజర్. ఈవెన్ ద సేమ్ పోస్ట్ ఈజ్ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ ఇన్ ది రైల్వేస్ ఆల్సో. ఇఫ్ యూ ఆర్ పోస్టెడ్ ఇన్ ది వర్క్షాప్ దెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ అసిస్టెంట్ వర్క్షాప్ మేనేజర్, వర్క్షాప్ మేనేజర్ అసిస్టెంట్. హియర్ ఆల్సో అసిస్టెంట్ వర్క్స్ మేనేజర్ ఓకే. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ అవర్ ఎంట్రీ లెవెల్ అండ్ హియర్ జూనియర్ వర్క్షాప్ మేనేజర్ అండ్ హియర్ ఆల్సో జూనియర్ వర్క్షాప్ మేనేజర్. దీస్ ఆర్ గ్రూప్ బి అండ్ ప్రమోటింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ గ్రూప్ బి టు గ్రూప్ ఏ విల్ టేక్ సమ్ టైమ్. Okay, so here after that you will become a manager or you know a chief mechanic, a chief workshop manager or chief works manager, whatever the designation is the highest, we are not worrying about that. Okay, so here also that is the thing. And what is your work here? So you have a different levels of workers here. The workers who is you know doing that work, like who is a for example to manufacture the bullet, then there you need to take some metal and you melt it and you make into different who will handle that casting process and everything. So the lower level people manages that, and above them there are some supervisors, and you are above them who needs to work with them. To work with them means you need to guide them and you need to supervise whether they are producing or whether they are meeting your demand or not. Okay, that is what your duty here. So Indian Ordnance Factory Services here. Okay, and here if salary same, facilities also same, like everywhere you have a group 4 or a group 3, type 4 or type 3 type of what we call that accommodation. Work nature is like that. See, work nature is here, for example, if I take the one, work nature is like a managerial. Managerial mean, see, you got the prototype and you need to produce that by understanding the technicality. So when you producing that, then you need to make your below people to complete that task. Okay, that is managerial. And technical also, technical means you need to understand what is the design and everything. That you can understand only if you have the technical knowledge. And apart from these two, they have a in-house R&D also. See, in-house R&D, they are not completely modifying the existing product, but they will make some more enhancements for the thing. Okay, that is how the in-house R&D will work. Okay, so in-house R&D, Hyderabad Center is famous, so they will do a lot of work. Okay, so and power and status. Power means they will be there in that production department only, so in that respect they have power there only. And see, these days what happened, the private entities also started producing the defense related products like Tata and Reliance, they entered in this defense. So they don't have people who are having this much experience, so they are trying to attract the senior level people. Okay, in that level, in that way you can say that you have a social influence to the other companies, private companies. career growth. So this is a time bound, but here this year they mentioned 000 for the Indian Ordnance Factory. Why? Because they are trying, they are, you know, going to corporatize this one. Okay, present so far it is they are calling it as a services because it's a government department. Now they are trying to make it as a PSU. This is a trying to make it as a PSU. It's no longer a service. Okay, you remember this. You know, the talks are going on. That is why this year they are not recruiting anyone. So you no need to worry about that. Okay. But I'm just explaining, like the competition, generally the people are recruited here from the ESC and then civil services. Civil services, not from the army. Okay. So most of the time civil services, you know, recruited through civil services, whoever got recruited, they will take care about the managerial issues and the personnel. Personal department, they belongs to personnel, but technical, you know, only the people recruited from ESC, they will take care about that. Okay. And work burden and family life. See, here work burden is from 9 to 6 job, 9 to 6 job. But sometimes you need to meet some demand, like if army is giving you deadlines, then you need to work hard to meet the demand. And family life, if you come to the family, the disadvantages of this one is like most of the facilities are remote areas and the work pressure also more here. Okay, why? Because if you need to meet some target, then you need to work hard. And there are some facilities in Hyderabad and Chennai, but those facilities are having more work burden. And if you go to the remote areas, okay, like Chandrapur in Maharashtra, and there is one more facility near Nagpur, that is also a remote place. But the work burden is less, but what happens there, it is a remote place. Okay, so in that way it may be a problematic issue if you are having a working partner. Not only here, in every service it is a problem, except the naval stores or some of our services where you will stay at one place. Okay, so that is about this. And see, coming to this, why I have written this Defense Aeronautical Quality Assurance Services, it is like a standard, it needs to enforce the standards and the quality. It needs to enforcing. Okay, it is enforcing the standards and the quality. They have some documents like whatever they are producing, is it as per the requirement? Are they using the quality material, or is it meeting the quality thing or not? And here, this is mainly, concerned about the, your aeronautical, quality. Like the parts related to the aircrafts, okay, or avionics, or okay, all related aeronautical thing, it is enforcing. So these people are Indian Ordnance Factory people are producing these, and these people are certifying that whether it is meeting the pass or not. Okay, so who is powerful here? These people. So if these people are not certifying it as qualitative or a standard one, then these people are in their trouble, the Ordnance Factory services. So that is why always they need to go around these people and make it work. Okay, and they also having the job, office time, morning to evening. They no need to work very hard. Okay, so the same type of organization, it is there in the railways also. The same type of, that is RDSO. See, railways is very, very vast, and there are so many opportunities in the railways. That is why many people are, opting railways as the first one. So we have RDSO. RDSO also it is also, quality and standards. Okay, it will enforce quality and standard, not only for the railways, it will enforce for so many other companies. Okay. And then, we have something like coaching, teaching jobs also in the railways. For example, training institutes. Not only here, everywhere we have training institutes. So who train in the institutes, who is the faculty, the fellows, whoever already have enough experience in the service, they will be, going to the training centers, and they will train the new entrants. Okay, this is also a very good job. Okay, so like that, you know, there are different types of jobs everywhere. Even if you take the Indian Ordnance Factory, we have in-house, you know, R&D. In the same way, railways also, we have an in-house R&D. In-house R&D means there is no special R&D, but if you come up with something, always they will implement that. Okay. So here, Indian Aeronautical Quality Assurance Services, okay, the number of posts are less, but facilities are, you know, same. This is also under the defense. So you will get the quarters, and then you will get the canteen, military canteen access, except the daru. And then work nature, and work nature is like that. You need to check, you know, whatever they are producing, you need to check that and see whether it is, you know, in accordance to your standards. Okay, you need to enforce the quality and the standard here. Power is, you know, more compared to these people. Why? Because if they are not, you know, accepting, then they will be in the trouble. And here work burden is less, and family, you know, balance also okay here. Okay.